Yes, thank you, Jan. That was absolutely amazing experience to listen to the paper. And thank you for bringing up all the Polish experience that we sometimes are just unable to express. And thanks to you being a bilingual and functioning between two cultures, that was really made possible. I really enjoyed it. Something that I wanted to add, perhaps, as a little comment, thank you for focusing not so much on what is being lost in translation, but rather what we gain through the translator and through his work. And with this encounter I had with one of the Polish theater directors a few, actually 2 years ago. He was working on Adam Mickiewicz's Dziady, the Forefather's Eve. And he was struggling with some moments in the play that he couldn't make sense of it. Obviously, the new generation playwrights, they have their own ideas. And then suddenly it dawned on him that actually he should go and see what Bible version Mickiewicz used when he was writing the Forefather's Eve. And then he figured out that it was the Wujek we had, you know, our St. James Bible version, it was Jakub Wujek. And then he actually read the whole translation, and Wujek, he shaped the minds of a few generations of poets, and then it suddenly everything it became so much more clear to him, you know, just getting the right words, not so much the any translation, but just Wujek's use of biblical discourse. So I really appreciate that you pointed to that. And then
thank you.
And mentioned it, yes.
Yes, and I actually, I have no experience of simultaneous change translation, and I know that I couldn't possibly do it. But, you know, so that's an aspect of the subject that's really, really interesting. And thank you very much.
It occurred to me that from what Eugene said, it transpires wonderfully that it is not actually a good translation that or a successful translation that does the job, but it is the effort of translating and the activity of translating that is in itself a hermeneutic exercise, which brings us closer to the poem. And even for the readers of bad translations, it is also a possibility to it offers a possibility of diving deeper. So just the effort, just the undertaking itself. It's already a moment of revelation for both the one who fails in his task and those who read the effects of that failed experience. But of course, so it's not only congenial causation that is a way of diving deeper.